Booster Fuels wants to be the Amazon Prime of gasoline.
Amazon set a new expectation for retail. People want to push a button, get same day free delivery. Well, we're able to do now the same thing for gasoline.
The company was founded in 2014 by former Boeing spacecraft systems engineer Frank Mycroft, along with co-founders Diego Neto and Tyler Ra. Companies with big parking lots partner with Booster and offer its service, often as a company benefit. You park in the lot, leave your fuel door open, tell the app you want some gas, and go about your day.
When you think about a gas station, it hasn't changed much in 50 years. So the concept is really taking this old world industry and leveraging mobile technology, machine learning technologies to allow us to deliver gas to people without any of the inconvenience.
You just fill it up like you normally would at a gas station. Then they come back, they see their tank full, and they're happy.
We are the only company quietly roaming through parking lots looking for cars. So the truck that does that has to fit within a single parking spot, has to maneuver as well as a small car, has to be connected to the cloud and communicating with all the other mobile distributed gas stations in the Booster fleet.
And Booster has attracted some big names. Its customers include Facebook, Pepsi, PayPal, and Frito-Lay. It currently operates in over 20 cities in three major regions, Orange County in the Bay Area in California, and Dallas-Fort Worth in Texas.
We've done more than 1 million deliveries company-wide, and we'll do about $180,000 of revenue in a single day.
Mycroft says that every time you get gas from a gas station, you're paying 40 cents a gallon on the lease of its property. That's not the case with Booster.
Anybody can make it so that you can push a button and get gas. But doing that in a way that doesn't cost more than the gas station is incredibly hard. We didn't want to have to build a subscription service. We didn't want to have to charge fees. And so our belief is, service everyone by charging the same price and focusing on where cars go all the time, parking lots.
Booster says that as a result of that decision, along with the technologies it's developed, it can keep its prices at or below what gas stations are charging.
To really be inventive today, you have to start from scratch with the context of what would this have looked like if you started it in the 21st century. It's hardware with embedded systems, with software that's communicating to the cloud, its procurement of fuel, its pricing to customers. When it all comes together, that's where the magic is.
When you're delivering a highly flammable liquid to 20,000 vehicles a week, safety is a big deal.
We built these trucks at same or greater standard of safety than the large 10-time capacity tanker trailers that you see on the freeways today.
With the growing popularity of electric vehicles, it's hard not to wonder if a gas-focused service like Booster has a built-in expiration date. But Mycroft is confident in the work the company is doing.
We like to be realists, that you look out your window, there are gas-powered vehicles, and that's going to be here for a very long time. Let's go and make them 3 to 5% better by improving the supply chain, reducing emissions, and reducing miles traveled. People spend more on gasoline than they do for all of e-commerce. People spend almost as much on gasoline as they do on groceries as a category. At the same time, we do look at alternative energy solutions. Nothing stops us from doing the same service for electric vehicles or other alternatives. It's all based on the same technology investments, software routing, logistics that works for fuel.
Booster has raised over $32 million and plans to expand both its regions of operation and types of service locations by early next year, including into three new states.
9 out of 10 Americans still drive to work, and they're either going to or coming from suburbs. I've got 2 little kids myself. I'm not going to put my 2 kids on top of a scooter and go to work or go to school. I need to have my car, and I need to be able to drive, and that's the infrastructure that makes up America. Imagine 10 years from now, not have to think about gasoline or energy in general, or things in general, just getting to you where it's most convenient for us to deliver to, most convenient for you to get it, and most cost effective for the entire ecosystem. I think that's the way that the world is moving.